Hello everybody, welcome to the last topic of module 6 in EC206 computer organization. This topic is dealing with memory segmentation and paging. Now what is memory segmentation? It is division of the computer's primary memory into segments or sections. Okay, so we are actually dividing the entire memory into segments. We had actually earlier seen something called pages, which is something similar to this. But now we are talking about a different thing altogether, which is called memory segmentation. So it is the division of the computer's primary memory into segments or sections. Now, a reference to a memory location, suppose you want to take data from a memory location or write into a memory location, for that you need to have a value that identifies which segment that memory location is in, and also an offset within that segment, where is your memory location offset within that segment. So a reference to a memory location includes a value that identifies the segment in which the memory location is, and within that segment, the offset within where that particular memory location is. Now, segments or sections are also used in programs. So in object files of compiled programs, when they are linked together into a program image, when the image is loaded into memory, you can have segments that are made. We had seen this when we had last learned the previous modules. We are only formalizing the way we are talking about that now. All right, so segments usually correspond to the natural divisions of a program. All right, so when we had talked about how a program is executed in a computer, we had seen such things like there can be a main program and individual subroutines. So actually there are natural divisions in the program. So you have individual routines, individual parts of the programs that can be considered to be segments. There can also be data tables, data that is going to be used by the program. So this segmentation is generally more visible to the person who is writing the program, okay, rather than paging, which was actually an inbuilt system. How we are deciding the number of pages, all those things are an inbuilt system. So the segmentation is more visible to the programmer than the paging. Okay, so different segments may be created for different program modules. That's what I said. You can have different subroutines, you can have different program modules that are working together. The linker takes the objects files of the various programs and joins them together to form the executable. So you can have different program modules, and they can be considered to be different segments. And also different segments may be created for different classes of memory usage, such as the text segment, the code where it is residing, that is another one segment. And then you have the data segments, okay? And certain of these segments may be even shared between programs. So in a system using segmentation, we have seen this previously, a memory address will consist of the segment ID. This is the value that tells you which segment we are talking about. Okay. And an offset within the segment, which tells you exactly where that memory location is within the segment. So before managing such systems using segmentation, the hardware memory management unit, which is called the MMU, is responsible for this. Okay. So the hardware memory management unit, MMU, is responsible for these things. Now, what all does it do? It translates the segment and offset into a physical memory address. So your memory address is coming as a segment ID and an offset. So the translation of the segment ID and offset into an actual physical memory address for performing memory read or write is done by this MMU. Okay. Another thing the MMU does is it performs checks. Now, what does it perform checks on? Whether this translation can be done, are these values valid? Okay, is there a memory location like that? Can the translation be done? Those kinds of checks are also performed by the MMU. Okay, and certain of these segments, right? And certain locations within each segments, there are various kinds of permissions allowed. Sometimes you are able to read and write, okay, into that segment. Sometimes you may be able to read only. Sometimes you may not even be allowed to read or write that segment, okay? Or for that, the MMU is the one that controls whether you are allowed to reference that. Reference means access that in a particular way, reading or writing, whether that is permitted. That is the role of the MMU. Now, segmentation can be with paging and without paging, Okay, let us consider segmentation without paging first. So there are only segments. We are not talking about pages within the segments now. So segmentation without paging, associated with each segment is the segment base. Now what is the segment base? Inside the memory, where is the segment located? That is given by a starting address that is called the segment base. Alright. So when a program references a memory location, when it wants to access a memory location, the offset is added to the segment base to generate a physical memory address. Okay. So this is segmentation without paging. So there are no paging over here. The implementation of virtual memory on a system using segmentation without paging requires that entire segments be swapped back and forth between main memory and secondary storage. We know that when you want to read something into the main, when you're bringing something into the main memory, and when you're writing back things from the main memory into the secondary storage, such as your hard disk, that process is called swapping. So when you're doing swapping, the whole segment has to be swapped. Maybe only very little bit of data has changed within a segment, but without, when it is in segmentation without paging, when you're going to swap back and forth between the memory, main memory and the secondary storage, okay, a physical memory and your virtual memory, that is what we mean, then the entire segment has to be written or read back and forth, okay. So now the problem starts. When a segment is swapped in, the OS has to allocate enough contiguous free memory to hold the entire segment. Now segments cannot be fragmented. They have to be placed in a continuous locations in the memory. So the OS has to ensure enough contiguous free memory to hold the entire segment. Now because of this, now what happens is memory fragmentation can occur. Now what happens here is that if there is not enough continuous or contiguous free memory, the problem called memory fragmentation occurs. The total memory that is free may be enough for that entire segment to be swapped back and forth, but inside the total memory, here and there might be data stored. So if there is not enough continuous memory to store the entire segment, then there is a problem. This problem is sorted out in segmentation with paging. So here we not only have segments, but we have also pages within the segments. So instead of an actual memory location, the segment information now contains the address of a page table for the segment. Okay. So the addressing is now a little different. So instead of segment in the you had earlier, you had a segment ID and an offset. Here now you will have the address of a page table for the segment. So when a program references a memory location, the offset is translated into a memory address using the page table. So it was segment ID plus offset, and now we have the address of the page table and the offset is translated using the page table. Okay. So a segment can be extended, that is, you can make the segment bigger simply by allocating another memory page. Okay. You can just make a segment bigger, extend it by simply allocating another memory page. And then you just have to add that to the segment's page table. Okay. So implementation of virtual memory on a system using segmentation without paging usually only moves individual pages back and forth. Okay. In the previous slide, we had seen that if it is segmentation without paging, if you want to swap segments, you have to swap the entire segment back and forth, and you have to allocate it contiguous free memory. Here, you don't have to move the entire segment. You just have to move individual pages back and forth. And these pages of a segment need not be contiguous. That is, if the pages are of one segment also, they can be stored here and there in the memory. They can be located wherever there is free memory in the main memory. So this reduces the problem of memory fragmentation.